Court sketches show Patrik Mathews looking unkempt, a far cry from his clean-cut Army Reserve look just 5 months ago. He spoke few words as he and his co-defendants faced charges, including transporting a firearm to commit a felony. The last time we saw Mathews, he was living in Beausejour, a small town an hour east of Winnipeg. Police had just raided his house and seized some firearms. Soon after, Mathews was released from the Canadian Army, where he was a reservist with explosives training. RCMP and the military were investigating his alleged role as a recruiter for the neo-Nazi group The Base when Mathews went underground.
This is a group that's been talking about committing acts of violence for a very long time.
The FBI alleges they made a functioning assault rifle, bought 1,650 rounds of ammunition, and practiced at a local gun range. Agents say they talked about recruitment, creating a white ethno state, and military-style training camps.
We're seeing threats of violence.
Just yesterday, Virginia's governor declared a state of emergency, temporarily banning all weapons around the state capitol. He cited intelligence that out-of-state militia groups and hate groups were planning to attend a pro-gun rally there on Monday.
They're not coming to peacefully protest. They're coming to intimidate and to cause harm.
The governor fears a repeat of the violence in Charlottesville, Virginia in 2017, which injured 28 people and killed one.
There will be a significant number of similar-minded people at this rally that also have access to weapons and could be another Charlottesville-esque type situation.
Back in the summer, Mathews' boss told us he didn't think his employee was a danger to others. Reached today, his grandmother didn't know about the arrests. She was just grateful he's still alive. Karen Pauls, CBC News, Winnipeg.